and a person can realize that God exists, not to have ever opened up the Bible and read not one scripture. God exists. So what do you mean? Well, let me see you make a mountain. Where's your sun? Where's your stars that you created? Let me see you. Let me see you make a tree. Let me see you make a river, an ocean. Where's yours? What man can do? No, that gives you a clue that there is an entity greater than you.
Those that's running and saying, I ain't going to church, I won't be too. That those are those that were just described. They love darkness.
You're just choosing not to believe. Darkness. Yeah. There's got to be somebody that made that ocean. Who was the man? What's his name? Where is he? Somebody put that mountain over there. Who did that? You know that's a greater entity than yourself, than humanity. You know that. You have no excuse. Now, whether you want to be enlightened or not is your choice.
So people that teach evolution, in their heart, they really know the truth.
Yeah.
But they're just...
Yeah. They don't want to choose. They make the choice to say, yeah, I came from monkey. You know, you did?
Yeah, I can say David said it even before the sun ever came, when I considered the heavens, the works of your hand, the moon, and all the stars.
What is man? You got to go into the scriptures again and then you're raising it out. Okay, praise God. All right. Look at Romans 2:14. Now here's something here that a people, the Gentiles, that was not given the Jewish customs and traditions and handed down from Abraham and Noah and all that. These people right here was not in on that. 2:14, for when the Gentiles, which have not the law, do by nature the things contained in the law, these, having not the law, are a law unto themselves. Romans 2:14. It's like Cain and Abel. Somebody can tell you, you can pretty much tell yourself it's good to do some things, and some things you have no business doing. That's your conscience. It's not good to kill a man, to kill somebody. It's not good to take somebody, other people's stuff. That's called your what? My conscience got to me. My conscience got to me all the time before I got saved. My conscience. I didn't have a preacher that I went to hear every week and nothing like that. It was my conscience that says, oh, you shouldn't steal. Well, if I did, that was terrible. You did, that was terrible.
Whether you got caught or not.
Your conscience just beat you up, whether you got caught or not. Your conscience got to you. What is that? That's your conscience. Who paid him? Nobody. Jesus did. Who gave him that job? Nobody. That's just your conscience. Now you can take your conscience and apply it to eternal life, and ooh, what a rocket ship! Or you can take your conscience and apply it to darkness, and what a rocket ship! It depends on where you put your conscience. Allow your conscience to be dictated by some by the word of God, some of it by Satan. It's a choice. And God says, "Y'all, are you without excuse? You know I'm a greater entity, and you know I'm out here." Yeah, so what's man going to do? Okay, all right, so now, go back to our lesson here, St. John. We're moving pretty good. Verse 10, I do believe. Someone read that if you will, please.
He was in the world was made by him, and the world knew him not.
Okay, we got two things in here, three things, actually. He was in the world incarnated. Okay, I gotta move. He was in the world incarnation. Creation, the world was made by him. And rejection, the world knew him not. He incarnated. He made everything that was in the world, and he was rejected by the things that he made. He came into his own. When he says his own, means the flesh of his creation. He came into the flesh of his creation, and his fleshly creation. And then you get revelation from Isaiah 53. But it was written thousands of years before John. See, that prophet was saying, speaking the word, the prophet was rhaming the word, he's rejected and despised. And then John came over here and was a witness to it and said, wrote it down and said, here's the Logos, reason this out. The guy over there in Acts 9, it could be Acts 9 or Acts 7, says, who is he talking about? Maybe let's try Acts 7 first. Maybe. I believe it's Acts 9, but I'm going to try Acts 7.
I think it's 9, too.
Oh?
I think. Yeah.
Where you got it?
Acts 8.
Acts 8, pick it up in verse 29. The Spirit said unto Philip, go near, join thyself to this chariot. Philip ran thither to him and heard him read the prophet Isaiah. That's Isaiah 53. And said, do you understand what you're reading? See, I'm reading and I need it. It's messing with my reasoning. And can somebody bring this out to me? And he says, how can I understand this except somebody do what God did? And Philip went and read that and taught the man. So the man realized that, who was he talking about? It was his question. To another person. Who's this writing? Was he writing about himself? Or was he writing about somebody else? Who's he writing about? And then, now, as we read St. John here, we understand years ago, Isaiah wrote that. A prophet been used by God, speaking the word, and now we hear, and I'm going to tell you, saints, and maybe I'll get shot for it, but your best explanation, your best comprehension comes from reading the word. It doesn't come from some prophet from over there, down here, down there, and he got a word of God for you. No, it doesn't come from even the rhema word is a good word, but it's not the best word. The best word is here. The spoken word is for unbelievers. The best place for the spoken word to hit is unbelievers. Romans 10. 9. How can they? See, then they is they that don't believe. How can they? Now God uses the fivefold ministry to what? Perfect us that are in the Word. Fivefold ministry is no good to those that are outside of the Word, except for that evangelist. He's the only one that can really hit those that are outside of the body of Christ is that evangelist. What does he say in Romans 10? We're moving real fast. Romans 10 and 10:15. How shall they preach except they be sent? So that's the preach word. How beautiful are the feet of them that preach the gospel of peace and bring glad tidings of good news. And I should be going on something. 14. How then shall they call on him in whom they have not believed? So you got to have a preacher. How can they believe whom they have not heard about? You got to have a preacher. And how shall they hear, there it is, without a what? Preacher. So a preacher is best place. It's those that ain't heard nothing. And those that have heard and become to believing, their best source is someone like Philip did to the eunuch. Let me break this down to you. That's what the fivefold ministry gift comes in building up the body of Christ. Build us up to perfection. And never said the fivefold ministry gift was to save the church. For some folks, it's the 5-foot ministry gift every Sunday. Preach salvation over and over and over and over and over. You got to bring them up to perfection. Give them strength. Okay, now we're going to see about this word getting out of here right quick. Verse 11 of St. John 1. He came into his own, and his own did what? Did receive him. But as many as received him, to them gave he power to become what? Sons of God, even to them that believe on his name. That power that he gave to them is the same power that you see in St. John 1 and 1. Strike up the music. He was born not of blood, nor of the will of the flesh. This power, this ability didn't come from your mom and your dad. The word was made what?
Flesh,
and it dwelt among us. We held his glory. Now sometimes his glory, his capability, shone through his flesh. What? Yeah, sometimes that glory that he had in the beginning, though he was made flesh, manifested in a body, sometimes that glory that he had in the beginning, existing in that body, became obvious. Really? Yeah. He could walk through a wall. He could walk off a cliff.
Disappeared.
So sometimes that glory couldn't stay in that body because that body was superior to the glory. But for the most part, he held back the glory and just worked out of a body and did it in human form. And so that we, you and I, can see that we can take advantage of that St. John 1 and 1 because the Word was made flesh, and we can put all that St. John 1 and 1 in us from top to bottom, and we can do what he did down here, live like he did down here, victory over sin.
Even greater things.
He said even greater things. Sometimes that glory is going to come through. It's going to supersede your human abilities. And you go, whoa, I didn't know I could do all that. Wow. Speak the word. Whoa, speak it. Get it. Whoa, man, I didn't know I had all that in me. And you'd be surprised. But if you're in darkness, darkness doesn't understand what you got. We got to get out of here. My time just won't let us go no further.